first of all, I want to tell you that this is the right time to invest in digital technology. Because digital doesn't mean only technology. It means try to master the technology in the most simple way. And this is the DTX software. The DTX software finally can convey all the digital information in order to create on a daily basis the virtual patient and plan the virtual surgery and the virtual prosthetics first in order to figure out in advance any type of aesthetic functional needs and personalize the implant treatment. So we start with the face of the patient, and then we go into the mouth looking for the interface between the soft tissue and the bone and how the prosthesis and the implant will go through such interface, because biology is as important as the biomechanics of the implant treatment. And that's why we don't want to talk anymore about guided surgery. We want to talk also about guided prosthesis, because we want to find out a way to drive in the proper position, in the pre-planned position, what we have planned in the virtual patient. So finally, we can deliver the implant exactly where we want, but we want exactly to deliver the temporary prosthesis in the functional and aesthetic position that we have planned into the DTX software. And we want to implement our tooling with technology that are easy to master with a proper learning curve. So we are going to talk about the latest guided approach, that it's a dynamic approach that will be able to position an implant without any kind of physical guidance, but with a virtual guidance that will allow you to precisely drilling through the recipient site according with the blue trajectory, that is the pre-planned trajectory of the implant that we decide according with the prosthetically driven and the soft tissue driven of each recipient site. And it's no matter if you are going to drill straight or angulated. What we can get advantage is from going beyond what we can see with our eyes, because the success relay on what is inside the patient anatomy. If we open a big flap, this doesn't mean that we can be safe and we can increase the predictability of the treatment. Maybe we can increase the predictability if we can see beyond the bone surface. And maybe working flapless, like in this case in which we remove the teeth of this terminal dentition and we prefabricated the prosthesis that will be driven into the right position. So with the navigation technology, we are not only preparing the implant site, the implant bed, but also the bed and the recipient site for this prosthetic pin that will allow us to simplify the relining part of the temporary prosthesis in order to reduce and minimize the prosthetic adjustment in the surgical theater. This is the before and after. And this is what's amazing, because for me, starting from a real patient, informing the patient about his problem with a true and easy to build up virtual patient, and then design the temporary restoration and deliver the temporary restoration in the patient mouth. So the virtual patient match the real patient during the surgery and during the prosthetic part of the treatment. And then with the DTX software, we can easily collect all the information of coming from the treatment, from the pre-op and the post-op orthopantomograph to any type of clinical picture, to any type of digital file. So now I want to invite my colleagues. This is the outcome of this case after 1 week Just to reinforce the message that we must be minimal invasive if we want to speed up the healing, if we want to achieve the proper MUCO integration that will be the key for succeeding over time with this type of complex implant-supported restoration.